The topic for this video is about transportation. And more specifically, we're going to be talking about how new technologies revolutionized transportation and actually made a growing nation smaller. So the story begins with an invention we've already talked about, which is the steam engine. In the last video, you saw how the steam engine allowed factories to be built anywhere. Well, the steam engine also had a major impact on transportation. Prior to the steam engine, horseback and covered wagon were the only way to travel. As you can imagine, that would be long. People didn't travel very much because it took so much time to get from point A to point B, especially over great distances. During the 1800s, different inventors began to experiment with the steam engine in vehicles, and they invented two major modes of transportation, the locomotive and the steamboat, that changed the way people travel. So let's first look at steamboats. You see a picture of a steamboat here. It has the water wheel that sort of paddles the boat, which is powered by the steam engine. This was invented in 1807 by Robert Fulton. The steamboat is not a great boat for ocean transportation, but is great on rivers where there's not waves and things like that. Wherever there was a river deep enough, people could now travel in large numbers up and down the river quickly, and it made people able to travel from point A to point B across the country in greater numbers. In addition, people started to think that if they expanded the amount of waterways the United States had for steamboats, you could open up transportation to more areas. The Erie Canal is one example of this. It was built in 1823. Basically, they just took land and used dynamite and blew up a big chunk of the earth and filled it with water, and now you have a place where the steamboat can go. This is obviously a huge achievement, and more people are going to be building canals to accommodate steamboat travel and trade. You see here, the Erie Canal actually connects the Atlantic Ocean to Lake Erie, and now this part, this river here, was already there, and it went this way. And there was a area where they had no river, so they dug it out of dynamite, and then it connected to another river that went into the lake. So now you can go from the Atlantic Ocean all the way to the middle of the country by steamboat or take other boats in. Huge, huge deal. Moving along, the railroad is another big invention of this time period. The Baltimore and Ohio Railroad began in 1828, and it was actually carriages pulled by horses, like you see here. But then a few years later, the first steam locomotive was built, and it was a primitive thing, looking more like this here in the picture. Unlike steamboats, railroads could go anywhere that you could put track, so they were a little bit more flexible. By 1840, there were 3,000 miles of track, mostly in the north. And railroads really changed the United States. People and products can move fast anywhere around the country. So the nation's getting bigger in terms of land, but you're actually able to go more places because of the transportation. One big feat in the railroad was called the Transcontinental Railroad. At first, you can only go so many places because there was limited track. But then people started to wonder, hey, what if we were able to connect the Atlantic Ocean to the Pacific Ocean all by railroad? You could travel literally across the country in just a couple days, where before it would have taken 5-6 months. The idea happens in 1853, and people question if it's possible or not. By 1860s, people are actually planning the building of this. The 1862 Pacific Railway Act provides the company that's going to construct the Transcontinental Railroad, as well as funding for the project. And the project's actually completed in 1869. And if we take a look at a map here, there was railroad tracks already existing from the Atlantic Ocean all the way to the, you know, Omaha, Nebraska area. And then one company built the Central Pacific, built from Omaha out west, and the other company built from California back east, and then they met in the middle, and then the whole country was connected by railroad. So in conclusion, the same steam engine that was used to grow factories is actually used to create trains and steamboats in the 1800s. These different types of transportation, like steamboats, provided people a quick method to travel across the country, and it could also grow trade, and people could travel and only a couple days get to what it used to take a couple of months. Steamboats could go wherever there was waterways, so people would build canals. Trains began in the 1820s, and thousands of miles of track were laid by the 1800s, throughout the 1800s. In 1869, you had a railroad that actually went across the entire continental United States. And these new methods of transportation are going to be really important, because as the United States gets bigger and more land is added, you need to be able to fill that land with people in order to make it, you know, worth something. As transportation changes and people are able to move more quickly, more and more people are going to use those transportation methods to actually populate the new areas. Also, resources across the country, like gold and different mineral resources that are going to be discovered out in California, can now be shipped back east. Goods from the east could be shipped west. It really changes the way the country thinks and operates. In class tomorrow, we're going to be looking more at the Transcontinental Railroad and how that changed the country.